Good morning, dear students. Welcome you all for the mathematics class. Today I am going to discuss 8th standard mathematics first chapter, rational numbers. Okay, before going to this chapter, you want to know about counting numbers. For counting, which numbers we are using? So we know that we are starting from 1, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. are known as counting numbers. These counting numbers also known as natural numbers. These all things we studied in earlier classes. Okay, so if we include 0 to this number system, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So this is known as whole numbers. Okay, including 0 to the natural numbers known as whole numbers. Okay, so how to represent it in a number line? That also we studied. A number line starting from 0 with equal distance, we can represent the numbers. Okay, 0, next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. Okay, so this is the right part of 0. Then what is the left part of 0? That also you studied. This negative numbers. So that also we can represent here, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. Okay, so this including these negative and positive numbers known as integers. Okay, integers. Clear? Integers means including negative numbers and positive numbers. Then listen, one more thing. What about 0? 0 is positive or negative? No, 0 is neither positive number nor negative. Okay, 0 is not a positive and not a negative number. Clear? Okay, so now we told about counting numbers or natural numbers, whole numbers and integers. Okay, then listen, take any two integers. Here I am taking 0 and 1. Between these two integers, any numbers are there? Yes, of course, there are many numbers. So I am taking 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 0.7, 0.8. That is fractions and decimals also there in between two integers. That is non-integers, isn't it? These numbers are non-integers. These are also between these numbers. Okay? So including these all numbers, that is these numbers also known as rational numbers. Clear? What is a rational number? So, rational number means a number that can be expressed in the form of A by B. Okay? If a number that we can express in A by B form, that number is known as rational numbers. Okay? So, rational number means A by B form. A number which can be expressed in the form of A by B is called as rational numbers. And one condition is there, B should not be 0. Clear? So A and B are any two integers and B not equal to 0. If B equal to 0 means what will happen? Division by 0 is not defined. Clear? So what is a rational number? That is our chapter, rational number. So what is rational number? A number that can be expressed in the form of A by B, where A and B are integers. Integers mean any integers and B not equal to 0. Okay? Now you understood what is rational number? So, 1 by 2. Is it a rational number? Yes, 1 by 2 is a rational number because 1 by 2 is in the form of A by B and 2 is not equal to 0 also. So, 1 by 2 is a rational number. Then what about 5? Is it a rational number? Can we express as a rational number? Of course. How? 5 we can write 5 by 1. Okay, so now 5 by 1 is in the form of A by B. So 5 is also a rational number. Clear? Then next, 2.5. It is a decimal. Is it a rational number? How can we express it as a rational number? Is it possible? Yes, it's also possible. That is 2.5. We can write 25 by 10. Okay. What is 25 by 10? What is the shortest form, shortest form? Five by two. Is it a rational number? Yes, 5/2 is a rational number. Okay, 5 and 2 are integers, and here the denominator is 2. It is not 0. So 5/2 is a rational number. So now we understood 5 and 2.5 all are rational numbers. So what is a rational number? A number that can be expressed in the form of A by B, where A and B are any two integers and B not equal to 0. Okay, now understood about rational number. Then our next topic, equivalent rational numbers. Is 1/2, 2/4, 3/6. So 1/2, 2/4, 3/6. That is 2/4 is also equal to 1/2. 3/6 is also equal to 1/2. Okay. So these 1/2, 2/4, and 3/6 are called as equivalent rational numbers, because these 1/2 and these rational numbers, these three rational numbers are equal. So this is known as equivalent rational numbers. Okay. Next topic, positive and negative rational numbers. All rational numbers except 0. 0 is not a, that we told already. So all other numbers are positive or negative rational numbers. Okay. So if, suppose if A by B is a rational number. A by B. Here, if A is a positive number, if A is a positive number and B also a positive number, means A by B is a positive rational number. So we know that in A by B, A and B are any two integers. So if A is a positive number and B is a positive number, means A by B is a positive rational number. Then second case, if A is negative, minus A, and B also negative, minus B, what we will get? This one we can write here, both side, numerator and denominator is a negative number, so equal to A by B. What we got? A positive rational number. Clear? Then if any one number, so in case of A by B, numerator is negative and denominator is positive, what we'll get? Minus A by B, a negative rational number. Okay. Then if numerator is positive and denominator is negative, that is A by minus B, that also we can write minus A by B. It is also a negative rational number. Okay. So what we told now, if A and B two integers, in that A and B are positive numbers, means we will get a positive rational number. If both A and B are negative, we will get a positive rational number. If any one number, numerator or denominator, is negative, we will get a, that is opposite sign, we will get a negative rational number. Okay, so the second topic also over. Then our third topic, standard form. Standard form of a rational number. Okay, we are taking one example, a by b. A by b is a rational number, and if a by b is in its lowest form and b is a positive number, then it is in standard form. Okay, let us take one example. 2 by 22, we know that 2 by 22 is a rational number. So how can we change it in this lowest form? So we can, if we divide this 2 by 2 and 22 also, you can divide by 2. So 2 by 22 we will get 1 by 11. Okay, so 1 by 11 is the lowest term here, lowest form of 2 by 22. So and here you look the denominator, denominator also positive number. So we can say that 1 by 11 is the standard form of 2 by 22. Clear? Okay. Then another example also, if you need, we can take. Two by minus eight, what is the lowest form? 1 divided by 2, 1. 8 divided by 2, -8 divided by 2, 4. So minus 4. Now what we got? 1 by -4. So 1 by -4, how can we write? -1 by 4. Okay, now denominator is positive. Therefore, -1 by 4 is the standard form of 2 by -8. Clear? Okay. Then I am going to our next topic, equality of rational numbers. Equality of rational numbers. Okay, so here we need to check. If I given two rational numbers, we need to check whether they are equal or not, whether the two rational numbers are equal or not. You can take two rational numbers, 1 by 8 and 5 by 3. 1 by 8 and 5 by 3. So we need to check whether it is equal or not. For checking it, we need to just cross multiply it. Cross multiply means we need to find out the product of here, first this numerator and denominator. Okay, this first rational, we need to multiply the first rational numbers numerator and second rational numbers denominator. So what we will get? 1 into 3 equal to 3. Okay, the next, first rational numbers denominator, that is 8 into second rational numbers numerator, that is 5 what is 8 into 5? 8 into 5 is it equal? No, it is not equal. Therefore, we can say that 1 by 8 is not equal to 5 by 3. 1 by 8 is not equal to 5 by 3. Okay, then we can take another example. Listen, we can take another example. -1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2 and 5 by minus 10. Okay, minus 1 by 2 and 5 by minus 10. So, multiply it. Minus 1 into minus 10. Product. What is minus 1 into minus 10? Equal to 10. Okay, these two product, numerator and denominator. The next, 2 and 5. 2 into 5 equal to 10. So now what we got? Here also 10. Okay, so what we can say that these two rational numbers, that is minus 1 by 2 and 5 by minus 10 are equal. So we can write these two are equal rational numbers. Clear? Okay. Then our next topic, that is very important topic, representation of rational numbers on a number line. Representation of rational numbers on a number line. Okay, so we need to represent 1 by 2 and negative 1 by 2 on a number line. Okay, for that we are drawing a number line. Okay, so we need to represent 0. Okay, so the same distance we need to take both sides. Here we need to mark 1 and here minus 1. Okay, we know that 1 by 2 is lies between 0 and 1 and minus 1 by 2 is lies between 0 and negative 1. Clear? So next we need to represent 1 by 2. Then look, what is the denominator here? Denominator is 2. So we need to divide this portion, that is this 0 to 1, this portion into 2 equal parts. Okay, we divided into 2 equal parts, that is 1 by 2. Clear? Okay, this is 1 by 2, then what about this 2 by 2? 2 by 2 is 1. The next, where is minus 1 by 2? So also we need to divide 0 and minus 1 into 2 equal parts. So here we can represent minus 1 by 2. So this is the point. 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. Clear? Okay. Then I will take one more example. Three by five. Represent 3 by 5 on a number line. So let's check how to represent number line. Okay, 0. We can mark here 1. Left side minus. Okay. So 3 by 5. 3 by 5 is lies between these two numbers. So, how we will do? What is the denominator here? 5. So, this 0 to 1 we need to divide into 5 equal parts. Okay. So, 5 equal parts. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, we divided it into 5 equal parts. So, what is first part? This 1 by 5, 2 by 5, 3 by 5, 4 by 5, 5 by 5. That is equal to 1. We need to represent 3 by 5. So, 1, 2, 3. This is 3 by 5. Okay? So, like that. What is this point? 1 by 5. This is 2 by 5, 4 by 5, 5 by 5 equal to 1. So like that, if minus 3 by 5 means like that, we can divide this part, that is 0 to minus 1 also, we can divide into 5 equal parts. Okay, and what is minus 3 by 5? This is minus 1 by 5, minus 2 by 5, minus 3 by 5. Minus 3 by 5. Okay, the next. Represent 8 by 5 on a number line. Here you look, numerator is greater than the denominator, isn't it? So, if the rational number like this means, first you need to change this into a mixed fraction. So, how to change that into a mixed fraction? You studied in earlier classes, how to change 8 divided by 5, one time, 1 into 5, 3. Okay, so how we will write it? 8 by 5, 8 by 5 equal to 1, 3 by 5. Okay, now we need to show 1, 3 by 5 on the number line. Okay, so 1 3 by 5 we need to represent. So 1 is a whole number, that is here. So 1 3 by 5 is after this. So we need to extend this line. Okay, now 1 2 1 and 2. Okay. So 1 3 by 5 is lies between 1 and 2. So this part, this 1 to 2, again we need to divide into 5 equal parts. So after 1 only, okay. Divided into 5 equal parts. Then 3 by 5. 1 by 5, 2 by 5, 3 by 5. Okay, so in this number line, this point represent 1, 3 by 5 or 8 by 5. Clear? Like this, we can represent minus 8 by 5 also. That is 0 to 1, minus 1. So minus 8 by 5 means minus 1, 3 by 5. So here you need to extend, minus 2 you need to mark, and minus 1 and minus 2. Between minus 1 and minus 2, you need to mark this minus 8 by 5. Clear? Okay. Okay. Now, today we can complete one more topic, that is absolute value of a rational number. Okay, absolute value of a rational number. Okay, so we know that we studied how what is the absolute value of integers. Okay, so we can take an example 3. What is absolute value of 3? 3 equal to 3. That is absolute value of minus 3. That is equal to mod minus 3, that is equal to 3. Clear? What is absolute value of 0? 0 equal to 0. This all we studied in earlier classes. Just change this into rational numbers. We can take one rational number 1 by 2. Okay. So absolute value of the rational number 1 by 2, that is mod 1 by 2 equal to 1 by 2 without sign. Next, absolute value of a negative rational number minus 1 by 2, that is equal to mod minus 1 by 2, that is equal to, we will get 1 by 2 without sign. Clear? Then absolute value of 0, you already know it is 0. This is the absolute value of rational numbers. Clear? So what is the absolute value of 3 by 11 is equal to mod 3 by 11 equal to 3 by 11. What is the absolute value of 11 by minus 8? This absolute value of 11 by minus 8 equal to 11 by 8. Clear? Okay. Absolute value of 3 by 11. 3 by 11 is rational number. Absolute value of a rational number. That is, you will get like this. Clear? Okay. Now, it's coming. Anyway, our topic over. Then one more properties are there. So, two properties. Properties of absolute value of a rational number. So, one we know that minus of mod A equal to A. Okay, next one. Mod of A plus B less than or equal to mod A plus mod B. Clear? Then next, it is product. Mod of A into B, absolute value of A into B is equal to mod A into mod B. Okay? So, these three also we need to study. Okay? So, some verification questions also there. We need to verify it by using some examples. Okay? That we can discuss next class. Okay? So, here exercise 1.1 is the, you need to practice it. Okay? So, some questions we done here, then you just practice it from home. Okay? So, then practice it. Write first chapter name. Write neatly the chapter name and definition of rational number and examples. Okay. Then equivalent rational numbers and standard form of a rational number and write it neatly. Clear? Then after that exercise 1.1 is the all you can do. You just try it. Okay. If you have any doubt means we can clear it later. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.